Welcome to my way of playing Tekkis. There are many different ways of playing Tekkis, but I prefer to play him as an aggressive pusher that doesn't spend too much time laying traps around the map, but instead tries to push if possible and stays in the lanes. Whenever you lay traps, you lose gold and XP from lane creeps, and if you get unlucky, you won't catch anyone in the traps. If you do catch someone and kill them, it isn't always worth the time you have invested, though it sure is fun watching them blow up. Note that I'm not saying that you should abstain from laying traps at all, just don't focus all your energy on it and thus fall too much behind in terms of your experience and items. So what are my qualifications to make this guide? Well, out of about 30 Tekkis games, I actually managed to win some of them. But anyway, I do think that this Rat Daughter Tekkis is an effective way to play the hero that rely less on getting some lucky kills with mines and is more about getting towers. But whatever the merits of this guide, at least you get to watch some cool explosions. I go off lane with Tekkis. Tekkis mid might work as well, but your teammates will scream at you and give up instantly if you tell them you are going mid. They are probably already close to doing that by just the fact that you have picked Tekkis. I therefore find it better to just go offlane, and Tekkis is actually a pretty good offlaner. His high armor can make it hard for a solo support to zone him out, and you can actually trade hits pretty efficiently. If they are too aggressive, you can suicide them, and thus get an easy first blood. Tekkis is best against melee safe laners. Heroes such as Slark only start with 2 base armor and can easily fall prey to your suicide. But if you're against a ranged farmer like Viper, you will have a hard time. I prefer taking suicide in the offlane first, since they will have a hard time pushing you offlane. You could take mines and TP to tower and place them, but you lose a lot of gold, and you risk that your opponents just sentry it or don't run into it at all. Their safe laner constantly have to watch out for your suicide, and at level 2 when you got mines, have to back off if you place mines in the creeps. When I get level 2, I like to lay them either a little behind my tier 1 tower or just to the sides of the creep path. I max mines and suicide first. Which one depends on whether or not I expect to get a kill with suicide or if I want the mines for pushing. If I just use suicide, I skill mines since the cooldown is so long that I won't be able to use it for a while. I of course level ultimate whenever I can. I also take stasis traps at level 10, but I don't really find it that useful. It can be a game changer, but it's very hard to get a decent stun off. I find it most useful when defending base, since you can really place a lot around your Raxes. For items, I start off with a Null Talisman and a set of Tangus. The Null Talisman helps you last hitting and harassing. I then get Boots and afterwards Soul Ring. Then I prefer getting Tranquils on Tekkis, since you will lose a lot of HP constantly using Soul Ring for mana. A Garnet Scepter is my next choice, since it gives larger cast range on your remote mines and allows you to clear a quick wave with just one remote, which is great when you push. It also makes it a lot easier to cast remote mines in teamfights. After that, I usually get an Eul Scepter, which helps with mana issues and can both work defensively if I get focused, or offensively to toss a fleeing enemy into the air and then plant a remote mine on top of him. After that, I either get Hex or Ethereal Blade. The E-Blade makes your remote nukes deal a lot more damage and keeps people in place for the remotes. But this is a luxury late game item, and the core items are just Soul Ring, Tranquils and Aghanims. When I use my remote mines in teamfights, I throw them in and then spam my hotkey for focused detonation to make them explode instantly. Note that if you lay mines at Rosh, you can buy a Void Stone and set it before 10 seconds to get more mana regen for free, though you do convert reliable gold into unreliable. When you push towers with landmines, clever opponents will wait for you to plant the mine and then fortify, thus making your mine useless. I like to walk right up to the tower and act like I will plant a mine, making them sometimes waste a fortify. Consider sharing unit control with your allies. Having a lot of traps takes a lot of map control, and you can easily lose track of them and lose a kill. If they abuse this, you can always just remove their unit control again. When using suicide, Remember that the most important thing is the enemy's armor. If they have high armor, suicide deals significantly less damage. When you place your landmines to clear creep wave, be sure to hit the melee creeps once if close, and range creep once if a bit far away, since the landmines will leave the creeps with very little HP. Before you use Soul Ring, you can drop Aghanim's and then pick it up again after using Soul Ring, which will make you gain some mana. Don't do it though if you are against endless heroes. You can also plant remote mines singly around the map, which can work as wards. By the way, Volvo, what is up with remote mines? When Tekis plant them, he tosses them into the air, but if he gets interrupted during the process, the remotes, which he has already thrown, just disappears from the air. It makes no sense. It should be changed so they don't disappear out of thin air, and if you don't want to buff him, just make him wait longer with throwing it, so when it's thrown, it can't just disappear in the air. Anyway, enough chit chat, now it is your time to blow stuff up. And when you run after your foes to get intimate, be sure to type in all chat, "Do not run, we are your friends!" If you like this guide, be sure to subscribe for upcoming content. I have also uploaded a short Tekis games where I talk more about the way I play the hero. You can find the link in the video description.